St. Francis of Assisi, born Giovanni di Pietro di Bernardoni, came into the world around 1181 or 1182 in the Italian town of Assisi. His father, a wealthy cloth merchant named Pietro di Bernardoni, had high hopes for Francis to follow in his footsteps. However, Francis lived a carefree and indulgent youth, spending his days in pursuit of pleasure and revelry. Around the age of 20, Francis experienced a profound spiritual crisis that would alter the course of his life. He was taken captive during a conflict between Assisi and the neighboring town of Perugia. This period of imprisonment and subsequent illness became a turning point for him. During his recovery, Francis began to hear a divine calling and felt a growing discontent with his former way of life. One day, while praying in the dilapidated church of San Damiano, Francis heard what seemed to be the voice of Christ coming from a crucifix, instructing him to go and repair my house, which, as you can see, is falling into ruins. Taking this message as a direct command, Francis sold some of his father's goods to fund the renovation of the church. This event marked the beginning of his commitment to a life of poverty, simplicity, and service to God. Francis's decision to renounce his wealth and worldly possessions angered his father, who disowned him. Stripping off his fine clothes, Francis embraced a beggar's life and began working on the restoration of other neglected churches. His reputation for humility and selflessness attracted followers, and in 1209, Pope Innocent III gave his approval for the formation of a new religious order, the Order of Friars Minor, or the Franciscans. The Franciscan order, founded on principles of poverty, humility, and brotherly love, rapidly grew in numbers and influence. Francis composed a simple rule for his followers, emphasizing a life of poverty, manual labor, and preaching the gospel. He and his friars traveled throughout Italy and beyond, spreading the message of repentance and compassion. St. Francis's love for nature and animals is legendary. He saw all of creation as reflecting the beauty and goodness of God. Stories abound of his ability to communicate with animals and even preach to them. The famous tale of him taming a ferocious wolf in the town of Gubbio exemplifies his love for all living creatures. In 1219, during the Fifth Crusade, Francis journeyed to Egypt, where he sought to convert the Sultan Malik al-Kamil. Although the conversion attempt was unsuccessful, Francis impressed the Sultan with his courage, humility, and commitment to peace. St. Francis's health began to decline in the last years of his life. In 1224, while praying on Mount Laverna, he reportedly received the stigmata, the wounds of Christ on his hands, feet, and side. He bore these marks until his death. Francis passed away on October 3, 1226, in the Portiuncula, a small chapel he had restored. His influence and legacy extended far beyond his lifetime. Pope Gregory IX canonized him as a saint in 1228. The Franciscan order continued to thrive, and various branches of the Franciscans spread across the world, carrying on the spirit of their humble founder. St. Francis of Assisi is remembered not only as a saint, but also as a symbol of humility, love for all of God's creation, and a deep commitment to living in accordance with the teachings of Jesus Christ. His impact on Christianity and the world at large is enduring, and his legacy is celebrated each year on his feast day, October 4th.